What's up, travelers? It's Eliz
and Derek
from Means to Travel, and we wanted to do a really quick video today about seven different quirks that we found at our Airbnb here that we're quarantining in that seem pretty different than what you might find in, for example, where we're from in the US. So let's just jump right in. So the first thing we wanted to talk to you guys about are the extremely narrow stairs that are in our Airbnb.
Which means that they are steep.
As you can see in this quick footage that we took, Derek's foot is literally longer than the step.
And I don't have big feet.
So it's something that we really always need to be conscious of when we're going up and down each story and hold on to the banisters. When we checked into this Airbnb, the host kind of warned us that people sometimes fall down these steps and to really look out. And they said
especially after drinking some wine.
And they said that these types of steps are very common here in the UK with buildings that were built around the turn of the 1900s. So definitely something that you might experience as well if you come here to the UK.
Okay, and number two on our list of little quirks is that, and you'll find this in a lot of places in Europe, but you know, something you might not be used to coming from the United States is there's a washing machine, but there's no dryer. And it's not a two-in-one where it turns into a dryer. There truly is no dryer. So for those who aren't used to it, you're gonna have to hang dry clothes. And you know, we're actually kind of used to that. We like it. It makes your clothes last a lot longer, but yeah, it's a little quirk about this place.
Yep, so you'll see right here in this footage that we have been hang drying so far and it's worked.
Yep.
And the third thing that we wanted to talk to you guys about and show you is that when you walk into the bathroom here in our Airbnb, you actually have to pull a cord in order to turn on the light. There's no switch. And again, that's not something that's extremely common in newer buildings here in the UK, but you might find them in ones that are a certain age. So in the evening,
buildings of a certain age.
Yeah, at nighttime, we always have to remind ourselves that the flip of the switch does not exist in the bathroom.
Yep. Now, the fourth thing that's kind of quirky about this place is that there are, in fact, two grills. One of them is like an electric one, like a griddle that you'd have in the United States. And then the other one is this really nifty old school one, which I don't know how works, but I plan to try to figure it out sometime between now and when we leave. Because I just think it'd be a lot of fun to like kind of grill some meat on there or something. Maybe figure out how to get some of the rust off. It'll be great. It'll be yummy.
If you watched our Ocado haul video from earlier in our quarantine videos, you'll see that we ended up purchasing some Angus beef patties. So it would be really fun to be able to try grilling burgers on this grill.
Yeah, but I think it might take charcoal, so we'll have to see.
And the fifth thing that's really quirky about this Airbnb, going back to the bathroom a little bit, is that there are no outlets in the bathroom, which means the hairdryer is actually placed in the hallway right outside of the bathroom. I think it's a really nifty setup that they kind of invented in order to solve for that issue. Yep. And have a hairdryer in this Airbnb, but it's definitely noticeable as soon as you reach the top of the steps.
So, yeah, there's like this cool little like hairdryer holster sort of thing going on. It's kind of fun.
Something that I'd never seen before, and we've been all over the world, so just wanted to show you guys what that looks like. And the sixth thing that we wanted to talk about, I did mention this a little bit on social media before, if you follow me there, but when we first got to our Airbnb the night before, we had not gotten our food delivery yet, so we ended up ordering some local takeout. And there's a ton of amazing Asian restaurants around here. Mm-hmm. And so what was really interesting to find out is when we got delivery, they don't always come with the utensils included with the food, and so we didn't have any chopsticks to use with the Asian food that we ordered. And so we went into the drawer to maybe try to track down a fork here at least, and lo and behold, they have reusable chopsticks at this Airbnb, which was so awesome because, I mean, I've never been in an Airbnb that gave us reusable dishwasher safe chopsticks, and it came in handy the first night. So they know what restaurants are around here that are good and that people might want to order, and they helped us out.
Okay, which brings us to the last and seventh thing on our list, which is that there's a really cool neighborhood cat. We think it's our neighbor's cat.
Derek thinks it's cool. I'm allergic.
Very neat, and he shows up whenever we have food, and that is a lot of fun for us. Well, for me, it scares the heck out of her.
Yes.
Because usually she's sitting with her back to the wall that usually comes over, and it's disconcerting for her.
I'm worried that this cat's going to jump onto my lap as we film this.
Bloopers.
Yeah.
So, I mean, almost every day now he's made an appearance. I think he studies parkour because he has a pretty good leap. It's really, it's fun. You know, I enjoy when he comes by, but, you know, I understand she's allergic, so a little less fun for her.
Yeah, but if you're into having animals, you know, at a B&B or an Airbnb where you stay, this place you would definitely find charming. So those are the 7 things that we thought were super quirky and fun about our Airbnb that we've noticed so far. Hopefully you guys agree.
It's cool lamps. I mean, there's other things. There's a lot of charm in this place.
Yeah, and,
we're really happy that we found it.
We'll try to do a tour of the full Airbnb that we'll post after we check out, so that way you guys can see what our full experience looked like. If that's something you're interested in, feel free to give a comment below and let us know, or just do a thumbs up on this video. We love to know whether or not you like the content, so hopefully you do, and thumbs up tells YouTube that this was a really fun one. And if you haven't already, definitely subscribe to this channel. We create travel content about meaningful travel and the means to get there. So we're documenting our trip here in the UK and would love to have you come back to hang out with some of our travel videos in the future. Thanks everybody for watching. Cheers.
Bye.
Happy travels. Bye.
Hey travelers, don't forget to subscribe and let's hang out more. Here are some links to other helpful travel videos on my channel, and press that notification bell so you don't miss any new and awesome travel videos to come.